Hello everyone, I am Sagar Bhanushali and I am going to talk about molecular switching. So what is molecular switching? In the previous video, we studied about the cascade of reactions which involve the activation and deactivation of proteins. So when a receptor gets activated, it transmits the signal through the plasma membrane, which activates a protein to relay the signal to another type of proteins. So when the receptor gets activated by a ligand, it transmits the message inside the cell through the cytoplasm, which activates a protein from its inactive form to active form. So the protein is converted into active form, which further conveys the signal to another type of proteins, and this alters the target cell. Okay, so the protein is activated and it relays the signal. But suppose if the cell wants to carry out the same signaling pathway in future, so the protein is needed at that time. So the protein again has to be converted into its original inactive form. So the conversion of a protein from its inactive form to active form is known as switching on of a protein, and the conversion of a protein from its active form to its inactive form is known as switching off of a protein. So this switching on and off of a protein are carried out by a set of proteins known as protein kinases. And another one is protein phosphatase. The protein kinases activates the protein from its inactive form by addition of a phosphate group to the inactive protein, which activates the protein and then it relays the signal. But the protein phosphatase, it removes this phosphate group from the active protein. So the protein kinase switch on the protein, whereas the protein phosphatase switch off the protein. The switching off is as important as the switching on of a protein, which so that the signal can be conveyed again and again, or the signal can be terminated, so that the same signal cannot be, the same signal does not disturb the cell. Okay, so the protein kinase, this was about the protein kinases and the protein phosphatase. So if I take up a signal, if I say this is the example, this is the receptor and the plasma membrane, the receptor gets activated and it sends a signal inside the cell. This signal involves a protein. So this protein is activated by the protein kinase enzyme by the addition of phosphate group. Okay, so the protein is activated. Okay, though, so after the activation, when it releases the signal to another protein, this protein is again inactivated by the protein phosphatase enzyme by the removal of the phosphate group. So the at first the phosphate group is added by the protein kinase. After the activation of the protein, when it relays the signal, the same protein is further converted to its original inactive form by protein phosphatase by the removal of the phosphate group. So this was about protein kinase and the protein phosphatase. Mostly the proteins that are have the intracellular signaling function are generally protein kinases. So this protein kinases first activate itself, and then it activates a set of protein kinases that further activates or alters the target protein. The target protein leads to the change in the morphological and chemical form of the cell for which the signal was conveyed. Okay. So this was about protein kinase and the protein phosphatases. Further, if I talk about protein kinases types, the protein kinases are further split up into two major categories. That is, first one the serine threonine kinases and second one the tyrosine kinases. The serine threonine kinases are the protein kinases which adds the phosphate group to the serine, majorly serine, or to the threonine group or to the threonine region of the amino acid. And the tyrosine kinase is the type of protein kinase which adds the phosphate group to the tyrosine region of the amino acid. Okay, so this was about protein kinase. A human genome consists about 2% of the genome which encodes for this protein kinase. But there are hundreds of different types of protein kinases which are responsible for the intracellular signaling. Further, another type of protein which is responsible for the molecular switching is the GTP binding protein. So, if I say this is the 7 transmembrane G protein coupled receptor, when it gets activated, it sends a signal inside the cell through the cytoplasm. The effector molecule gets activated. In this case, the activation and the deactivation of protein is mainly by the GTP and the GDP type of molecules. When the GTP is bound to the protein is activated. When the protein is bound with GTP, the protein is activated. When the protein is activated, it relays a signal. After it relays a signal, due to the GTPase activity, this GTP is again broken down. The phosphate group of this GTP is cleaved and it is converted into GDP. It is similar as the protein kinase type, where in the G protein coupled receptor, when the GTP is bound, the protein is activated. Further, with the removal of the phosphate from the GTP, the GTP gets transformed to the GDP, which leads to the inactivation of the protein. So, with this GTP to GDP conversion is due to the GTPase activity. Further, the GTP binding protein is further of two types, the large trimeric GTP binding proteins and the small GTP binding proteins. The function of both the type of proteins is generally relaying of the signal through the proteins, but the small molecular GTP binding proteins functions as the regulating of the vesicular traffics. So, this was about the GTP binding protein. First of all, what is molecular switching? It is the inactivation and activation of protein by different kinds of proteins. Other proteins like protein kinases, which add up a phosphate group to the proteins and activates them, and the protein phosphatases, which removes the phosphate group and further deactivates them. The protein kinases are further of the two types, serine and threonine protein kinases and the tyrosine protein kinases. The serine and threonine protein kinases adds up the phosphate group to the serine or threonine region of the amino acid, while the protein kinase adds tyrosine protein kinase adds the phosphate group to the tyrosine region of the amino acid. Further, the GTP binding protein is another type of protein that is responsible for the molecular switching. This switching is due to the GTP and the GDP. When the protein is bound to GTP, the protein is activated. Further, due to the activity of GTPase enzyme, which cleaves the phosphate group from the GTP, it gets converted to the GDP. So, when the protein is bound to GDP, the protein is again brought back to the original inactivated form. So, this was about molecular switching. If you like my video, please do like, subscribe, share. Thank you.